Καλησπέρα σας. Είμαι η Μαρίλτα Πουζογλου, μέλος της ομάδας Coaching School στην Ελλάδα. Σας καλωσορίζω. Ναι, αν μπορείτε να κλείσετε λίγο το μικρόφωνο σας. Σας καλωσορίζουμε όλους και όλες σε αυτή την παρέα που θα είμαστε εδώ απόψε το βράδυ. Είναι μεγάλη χαρά μας που είστε όλοι εδώ, στο webinar. Εύχομαι να το χαρείτε και να σας φανεί χρήσιμο. Κάποια πρακτικά ζητήματα πριν συνεχίσουμε. Βλέπω βέβαια ότι ο Άβη ξεκίνησε ήδη να κάνει record. Αν κάποιος έχει πρόβλημα να φανεί το πρόσωπό του, μπορεί να κλείσει την καμερά του. Και επίσης, τα μικρόφωνά σας να είναι κλειστά για να μην έχουμε τις παρεμβολές. Στο τέλος, θα προσπαθήσουμε να δοθεί λίγος χρόνος για ερωτήσεις που μπορεί να έχετε. Και αν δεν τα καταφέρουμε, μπορείτε να τις γράφετε είτε στο Facebook, στη σελίδα μας, ή να τις σημειώσετε και να μας στείλετε με ένα email για να σας απαντήσουμε. Δίνω το λόγο τώρα στη συνεργάτη μου, τη Μαρκέλα Μασούρα. Μαρκέλα.
Καλησπέρα σε όλους. Πολύ χαιρόμαστε που είστε όλοι εδώ μαζί μας. Θα ήταν πολύ πιο ωραία να ήμασταν όλοι από κοντά, αλλά δεν γίνεται.
Τι
να κάνουμε. Οπότε το θέμα σήμερα του webinar, όπως ξέρετε όλοι, είναι η εξάντληση που βιώνουμε και οι δυσκολίες που βιώνουμε σε αυτή την πρωτόγνωρη περίοδο για όλους μας. Πριν μιλήσουμε λοιπόν για αυτό το κυρίως θέμα, το οποίο θα αναλάβει ο δάσκαλός μας, ο Άβιο Γκόρενμπαρ, θα θέλαμε να δώσουμε λίγο χρόνο για να καταλάβετε και να καταλάβουμε όλοι, να γνωρίσετε το ποιοι είμαστε, ποιο είναι το Jungian Coaching School, αλλά και γιατί ένας Jungian Coach ή ένας Coach και ένας Jungian Coach είναι ένας ειδικός ο οποίος μπορεί να βοηθήσει σε ένα τέτοιο ζητούμενο. Με αυτή τη λογική λοιπόν, το webinar χωρίζεται ουσιαστικά σε τρία μέρη. Το πρώτο μέρος, να σας πω έτσι όσο πιο γρήγορα μπορώ, ποιοι είμαστε. Μετά θα γίνει μια συζήτηση μεταξύ της Iris Μπαλόγλου και του Avi Gorenbar στο ρόλο ενός coach και ενός Jungian coach και πώς αυτός μπορεί να απαντήσει σε αυτό το θέμα. Και μετά θα μοιραστείτε όλοι μαζί και θα υπάρξει και διάδραση με τον Avi Gorenbar.
Μια σεμινάριο που ζήτησα εγώ, μωρέ, την εταιρεία μου το πληρώσει.
Να κλείσουμε
λίγο. Μαλακία, τώρα. Το έχω ξεχάσει, όχι, το έχω ξεχάσει. Είναι 7 η ώρα, αλλά θα φτάσουμε.
Να κλείσουμε λίγο τα μικρόφωνα. Okay. Λοιπόν, χωρίζεται λοιπόν σε τρία μέρη το webinar. Λοιπόν, μου είπαν οι συνεργάτες μου ότι μέσα σε 5 λεπτά θα πρέπει να σας περιγράψω ένα πρόγραμμα. Ένα πρόγραμμα το οποίο έχει πάρα πολύ βαθιά γνώση. Ξέρετε όλοι ποιος είναι ο Carl Gustav Jung. Και ένα πρόγραμμα δημιουργημένο από ένα μεγάλο δάσκαλο, τον Dr. Avi Gorenbar. 5 λεπτά μου φανήκαν αδύνατο να το κάνω, για να σας είμαι ειλικρινής. Για να το καταφέρω, λοιπόν, είπα, οκ, okay, Μαρκέλα, κάτω δικό σου. Ήμουν κι εγώ κάποτε μαθήτρια αυτού του προγράμματος και σκέφτηκα λίγο πώς θα το κάνω μέσα σε 5 λεπτά. Το πρώτο πράγμα που μου ήρθε στο μυαλό μου είναι οι πολικότητες. Οι πολικότητες για τις οποίες χαρακτηρίζουν τη θεωρία του Jung, όλη τη φύση μας, η οποία δεν υπάρχει φυσική οντότητα χωρίς πολικότητες. Έτσι σκέφτηκα θηλυκό, αρσενικό, ισορροπία στις δεξιότητες, δεξί-αριστερό, ημισφαίριο και κάπως έτσι λοιπόν κατέληξα στο πώς να σας παρουσιάσω σήμερα. Να κάνω μόνο share screen, ένα λεπτό που πήγε αυτό. Να σας παρουσιάσω σήμερα το ποιο είναι το Jungian Coaching. Δώστε μου ένα δευτερόλεπτο. Βλέπετε όλοι? Αυτό που βλέπω.
Όχι, δεν έχει ανέβει τίποτα. Εσένα βλέπουμε, Μαρκέλα.
Να το. Ωραία. Τώρα, το βλέπουμε όλοι. Μια απάντηση από κάποιον.
Ναι,
βλέπουμε.
Ναι.
Ωραία. Έτσι λοιπόν, σκέφτηκα λοιπόν το θέμα των, όπως σας είπα, το θέμα των πολικότητων και πήγε το μυαλό μου στο δεξί και στο αριστερό ημισφαίριο. Και λέω 5 λεπτά κάτι θα μπορέσω να κάνω και ξεκινάω λοιπόν να απαντήσω την ερώτηση με το αριστερό ημισφαίριο που σκέφτηκα το πιο εύκολο από το να πεις νούμερα, Μαρκέλα. Νούμερα, λοιπόν, πολύ γρήγορα να σας πω ότι στην Ελλάδα είναι η δεύτερη γενιά. Στις άλλες χώρες έχουμε και πέμπτη και έκτη γενιά. Μιλάμε για 6 ενότητες, οι οποίες περιλαμβάνουν ένα πάρα πολύ περιεκτικό πρόγραμμα. Μιλάμε για 19 γεμάτες μέρες θεωρίας και εξάσκησης για 125 διδακτικές ώρες, γύρω από 50 ώρες ατομικής εξάσκησης, 18 ώρες σε μικρά groups, 99 ώρες πιστοποιημένες από τον Διεθνή Οργανισμό ICF, 60 ώρες ACSTH εγκεκριμένες, το οποίο είναι και το διαβατήριο για να γίνει κανείς ένας διεθνής coach, το πρώτο διαβατήριο, γιατί υπάρχουν και άλλες βαθμίδες. Και μιλάμε και για 39 ώρες επιπρόσθετες για να μπορέσουμε να ανανεώσουμε μια διαπίστευση ή να διεκδικήσουμε ένα ανώτερο επίπεδο διαπίστευσης. Αυτά είναι τα νούμερα. Εμένα δεν μου λένε πολλά τα νούμερα, για να σας είμαι ειλικρινής, και είπα να περάσω στο δεξί ημισφαίριο. Στο δεξί ημισφαίριο, λοιπόν, σκεπτόμενοι πώς να το πω όλο αυτό, είπα να ενεργοποιήσουμε τις αισθήσεις μας και να πάμε με το μη ορθολογικό κομμάτι του μυαλού μας και να σας περιγράψω το Jungian Coaching σαν μια συνταγή. Σαν μια συνταγή μαγειρικής. Μέχρι που σκέφτηκα να πάρω μια κατσαρόλα, λέω μην το παρακάνεις στη δημιουργικότητα. Αν ήταν λοιπόν μαγειρική, τι μυρουδιά θα είχε, τι γεύση θα είχε, τι μοναδικό θα είχε. Έτσι λοιπόν είπα ότι για να πω μια συνταγή, το πρώτο που πρέπει να σας πω για τη συνταγή αυτή είναι ποια είναι τα συστατικά. Στα συστατικά λοιπόν αυτά θα έβαζα πρώτα απ' όλα το ότι εκπαιδεύουμε σε δύο γλώσσες, στα αγγλικά και στα ελληνικά. Πολύ σημαντικό. Αγγλική είναι η business γλώσσα, ελληνικά είναι η γλώσσα μας στην Ελλάδα. Το δεύτερο είναι συστατικό είναι ότι εξασκούμαστε στη μητρική μας γλώσσα, πάρα πολύ σημαντικό. Το τρίτο είναι ότι ενσαρκώνουμε, βιώνουμε, γινόμαστε, μπαίνουμε στη διεθνή διάλεκτο του coaching. Επίσης, ένα άλλο κομμάτι που είναι πολύ σημαντικό συστατικό είναι ότι δεν δουλεύουμε μόνο ορθολογικά. Και ίσως αυτό να είναι και ένα από τα μοναδικά αυτού του προγράμματος, είναι ότι δουλεύουμε με το μη ορθολογικό κομμάτι μας και αυτό είναι κάτι πάρα πολύ μαγικό. Επίσης, δημιουργούμε ένα μοναδικό κλίμα διδαχής, χωρίς ίχνος κριτικότητας, με πολύ πάθος και αγάπη. Νομίζω ότι αυτό είναι το ταλέντο του δασκάλου μας. Βέβαια, σκεφτόμαστε γιουνγκιανά, κάτι το οποίο δεν μπορώ να σας το μεταδώσω. Μπορεί όμως σε μια μισή ώρα έτσι να έχετε πάρει μια γεύση το πώς μπορεί να σκέφτεται γιουνγκιανά κάποιος. Τώρα, κάθε συνταγή μετά από τα συστατικά της χρειάζεται και μεθοδολογία. Η μεθοδολογία μας, δεν θα μπω παρακάτω σε αυτό, δεν θα πλατιάσω καθόλου. Έχει τέσσερα πράγματα. Πρακτική, παρατήρηση, βίωμα, εποπτεία. Πρακτική, παρατήρηση, βίωμα, εποπτεία. Και μετά το πρόγραμμα, ένας Jungian Coach δεν τελειώνει εκεί, γιατί μπαίνει σε μια διεθνή κοινότητα με άλλες χώρες που μιλάμε όλη την ίδια γλώσσα. Συναντιόμαστε κάθε χρόνο ή κάθε δύο χρόνια σε κάτι έτσι πολύ ωραία conferences που γίνονται και περνάμε πάρα πολύ καλά, αλλά και συνεχίζουμε να ενισχύουμε και να καλλιεργούμε όλα αυτά που μάθαμε. Τέλος, υπάρχει και σε κάθε συνταγή ο σεφ. Ένα σεφ που θα έχει που θα είναι γνωστός και θα είναι, δεν ξέρω, Michelin, chef ή ό,τι άλλο πει κανείς. Για μας λοιπόν η εγγύηση της επιτυχίας μας είναι πραγματικά οι πρωτοπόροι επαγγελματίες δάσκαλοι μας. Ο αγαπημένος μας Άβη, για τον οποίο θα μπορούσα να μιλάω κανένα τέταρτο για το τι έχει κάνει, οπότε θα σας τα πει και ο ίδιος, και για την Ήρης την Παλόγλου, που είναι η νέα μας, γεια σου Ήρης, η νέα συνεργάτης και δασκάλα του προγράμματος, η οποία θα διδάξει και την ενότητα 2 για τις δεξιότητες του ICF. Είναι διαπιστευμένη Ελληνίδα, PCC coach, επίτροπος του ICF και πολλά άλλα. Τέλος, υπάρχει και ένα μυστικό, όπως οι γιαγιάδες μας που κρατάγανε ένα μυστικό όταν μας δίνανε τη συνταγή. Το μυστικό είναι ότι το Δεκέμβριο που θα ξεκινάει και το πρόγραμμα στην Ελλάδα, θα έχουμε και ένα εγχειρίδιο. Επίσημο εγχειρίδιο που θα εκδοθεί από τις εκδόσεις Routledge του Λονδίνου με εισαγωγή στο Jungian Coaching. Κάπως έτσι λοιπόν σας περιγράφουμε το ποιοι είμαστε για να δώσω το λόγο στην Ήρης. Εδώ θα
δώσω.
Για να δώσω τον λόγο στην Ήρης και στον Άβη για να πάμε λίγο να δούμε γιατί ένας coach μπορεί να είναι αυτός ο πιο κατάλληλος που θα μπορέσει να δουλέψει μαζί σας και να μας πει να πραγματευτεί αυτό το τόσο κρίσιμο ζήτημα που είναι η εξάντληση στις μέρες του κορονοϊού. Αυτό από μένα. Δίνω το λόγο στην Ήρης και στον Άβη. Άβη, Ήρης, welcome. We welcome you.
Θέλω είναι τελικά. Καλησπέρα
από μένα. Είμαι πολύ χαρούμενη που βλέπω σήμερα αγαπητούς συναδέλφους, καταξιωμένους στο χώρο, που ήρθαν να μάθουν τι είναι το Jung and Coaching, μια καινοτομία στο χώρο μας, μια καινούργια σχολή που έρχεται με νέα δεδομένα να μας διευρύνει την οπτική της προσεγγίσης. Και ας ξεκινήσω με τον Άβη. Hello, Άβη.
Καλησπέρα σας από το Τελαβίβ, Ισραήλ. Τι κάνετε?
Παρακολουθώ μια συνέντευξη. Για το
κόσμο. Με παρακαλώ να κλείσετε τα μικρόφωνα.
Συγγνώμη, το μήπως εδώ είχα ανοιχτό το μικρόφωνο. Κλειστό, δεν το έχω.
Κλειστό,
το
Μαρίλη, μπορεί και όποιος έχει το hosting να κλείσει και να
ανοιχτεί. As Maria told me, because you are the host, whenever, if, can you make us co-hosts, or if you see someone with an open mic, can you close it, please?
I will make you co-host because I cannot concentrate
at the same time. I will do it for you.
So, Markela is co-host, and let's see if I can do you co-host as well. Yes, okay.
Bravo.
Good. Now I don't know how to unpin you because I want to see Irid. But let's move on.
Iris,
can you see me now? Okay, let's start. Hello, Avi. Thank you for the opportunity to be here and discuss about Jungian coaching. Before we start, I would like to ask you, what does coaching mean for you? You, actually, what does coaching mean to you?
Well, can you guys close your microphone? Yeah. For me, coaching at the age of 67 is a metamorphosis because I have been a clinical psychologist for most of my life and expressive therapist, and I arrived to the coaching domain coincidentally. I was teaching at the Tel Aviv University in organizational consultation, and I came up with an idea to do a seminar, practical seminar, symbols and archetypes in organizations. And I found out when my students went to the field and used my tools that it's a magic. And this I was sucked in slowly, slowly. Right now, I'm graduating the third module of CTI coaching to become a certified coach. And then on my grave, maybe not on the stone, but on the other one, it will say a certified coach. Let me tell you, Iris, you know, in our age, when we have already quite not few years of experience, it is so lovely to acquire a simple, humanistic, straightforward, and enabling profession. I enjoy a lot because it's like a good wine. What I learned all throughout my years serves me now in within the framework of coaching.
Mm-hmm. Good. So we all know Carl Jung and his work on psychotherapy. But would it be interesting for you to tell us his theory application on coaching, and more specifically, how does Jungian coaching differ from psychotherapy?
You see, there is a worldwide movement to translate esoteric knowledge into practical life. For example, in America, Rabbi Berg translated Kabbalah into practical Kabbalah, and now it's widespread. Even Madonna was studying it. Same with Zen Buddhism. Carl Gustav Jung's psychology is on the one hand very, very clinical. He was a psychiatrist, but on the other hand, he was influencing what not, architecture, philosophy, the cinema world, and so on. I learned Jung for 6 years in the Jerusalem school for 3 years and many, many years of Jungian supervision and psychotherapy. And because I'm a very practical person, I took his theory and translated it into Jungian coaching tools. There is a kit now, and these cards that I'm using to teach the coaches enable a coach to have a third dimension, to have another point of view at his coaches' dilemma that are brought in the in within the coaching process.
So I keep that you have, if I understood well, it's a third dimension to coaching. Yes?
Third dimension, and let's put the right word into that. And correct me if I'm mistaken, in all the other coaching methods, no one is using the unconscious. What I study now in CTI is beautiful. It has to do with modes of communication, facilitating a person to get to know himself, thinking positive, thinking between options. But the added value of Jungian coaching is that a person doesn't even know how fruitful, how efficient and how practical the unconscious is. And Jungian coaching has tools to dive into the unconscious in the presence of a dilemma and find out very creative solutions. So it's really a magic.
Lovely. So let me ask the second question. Suppose I'm a coach, a client, and I'm coming from the corporate environment and I visit you, Mr. Goren. How am I secured that I will be coached and not have psychotherapy?
Thanks for your question. Listen, yesterday I just ended a weekend with my school in Budapest, Hungary, and the module was 24 leadership in corporation. So, well, if you come from corporate life, you would very likely come with a dilemma. I need to show you where your dilemma is lying on four domains that every corporation or organization has. Let's go very briefly. On the upper side, imagine a circle. On the upper side, there is people, which is HR, and there is learning, which is research and development, R&D. And on the lower side of this circle will be FIRE, which is results, a CFO, finance department, and the CEO sits in the stabilization, the grounding that is overseeing the whole corporation. Now, each one of those four domains is moved, is protected, is run by three archetypes. And when I hear your dilemma, I know as a Jungian coach how to locate your dilemma on the particular domain of the corporation. I figure out from the story you tell me to which archetype you naturally connect and which is your inferior archetype. That is to say, this field of coaching where you want to empower yourself. So there is nothing to do here with psychotherapy, once or ever. No psychotherapy, no intention to go deep. Why? What is your future? Mama, papa, Oedipal? Nothing of that. Very, very practical. Goes, give me the dilemma. We'll translate it into the domain in your corporation. See which archetypes you want to use and experience and expand your leadership potential.
So we hear about archetype. This is the new that actually we have not learned previously.
Can I tell you, please, what is an archetype? Because this is a Greek,
yes.
The origin is Greek bombastic word. So an archetype is a psychological database that contains traits, behavior, feelings, and visuals, and it comes up to the conscious level through a visual. This is why it is so illustrative and easy to grab and understand. The archetype has bipolar characteristics. For example, mama, mother, yeah, imatera. She brings life, but we are burying our dead in Mother Earth. So it's a bipolar symbol. And the archetypes in Jungian coaching serve as database to expand the personality of the coachee.
Very nice. Talking about your program and applied before in other countries, as we know, What is the uniqueness actually that you present with the Jungian coaching?
First of all, I must tell you that all those wise innovators eventually or actually were born here in the Holy Land. So I, like Jesus, I did my way, long way. First, I started first generation in Zagreb. Then a lady from Ljubljana took the program from Zagreb and moved it to Ljubljana. We have now five generations of Slovene, and they cover all the Adriatic area. Then a friend of mine introduced to me the president of ICF of Turkey. And I said to him, Sami, come learn in Slovenia Jungian coaching. So he came with a team of six people and they started the Jungian coaching in Istanbul. Then Markela and Marili and other wonderful people came to Istanbul and they moved it to Greece. And then a guy heard about it in Budapest. And actually in February, I will start an online Jungian coaching for the people in countries that don't have domestic schools. Luckily enough, you have a domestic school. I'll come teaching there, and Greek people can really benefit from the local program.
And what about the uniqueness?
Yeah, the uniqueness, the added value. Well, there are several components that make it very unique. One is really the ability to dive into the unconscious. The second one is it is an extremely creative program and tools. You are developing your emotional EQ because all these innovative ideas that come from the unconscious need to be absorbed in the ego, in the conscious level, and this is causing emotional involvement. It is very practical because we develop tools for every problem that you have in life coaching or corporate coaching. We have tools to deal with the shadow. We have tools to deal with femininity and masculinity. We have tools to develop with processes of career, the hero quest. We have tools to develop a leadership. We have tools for assessment, original tool for assessment. So when you have to accept an employee and you do an interview and you read the CV, you get extra tools to see the unconscious of the employee. And I think it's, even if you're a practicing coach, it will enrich your toolbox. And if you are not a practicing coach, you get 2-for-1 because you can learn Jungian coaching and you become a certified coach. Plus, you improve your English.
Of course. I keep this the assessment that you mentioned before, Avi, because we, the seasoned coach, when we go to a client and before we start the coaching, usually we are asked to use an assessment because we cannot judge theoretically what is going on with the people. So if we have this unique tool, I think we can do better.
Not only that, these tools are very easy. And later when I will lecture about burnout, I will use two of the assessment tools. One tool to explain what is burnout in Jungian terms. And the other one is to seduce the audience to be curious about diving into the unconscious, because here I tell you a promo for my lecture that the only solution for burnout is to dig in the unconscious and renovate yourself through fresh material that you're not acquainted or you're not aware of.
Very interesting. I've seen Avi before some cards. What are these Jungian cards and how they are different, they differ from other coaching cards that we know all of us?
Yeah, this is funny because, for example, the cards of point of view are also invented and produced in Israel in the village where my eldest son is living. So everything remains in the same boat. But in order to use the kit of the Jungian coaching tools, you must know the wisdom that is behind the tools. You must be acquiring the knowledge that is behind the tools. Each tool that we are using is based on a Jungian archetype. For example, if we go to the Hero Quest, you have to know the stages, and you have to know which stage corresponds to a problem on a career. For example, if you got stuck in your career, you are in the belly of the whale. For example, if you fell into corruption, you are in falling in love with the temptress, with your temptations, and so on. So this, in 6 months, these 6 modules that we teach enable you to use the cards. And this is the challenge here, that you can use the cards like a medical doctor if you know the anatomy of the body. You cannot possibly use the stethoscope if you don't understand what is a heartbeat, right? So I urge people to study, to learn, and then benefit from the tools. Thank you.
And if I have the time, I can place my last question. Avi, you are a clinical and educational psychologist. You are art therapist. You are a seasoned coach. Who is the most effective coach according to Jungian coaching?
It's a person that is not naive. Because of only one reason, because the human psyche is very complex. It's like a kaleidoscope. So you cannot be naive. And if you come to our program naive, you come out very clever. You become a trickster. So a great coach is, or a great Jungian coach is, a person that acquired the knowledge, but is both clever and courageous. You have to be courageous because the coachee wants to develop, but there is a trap here. There is no development without suffering. There is no change. You don't give birth to a child without suffering, and every change requires a cost. So a good coach is a person that is not afraid of life, that is not afraid to go with the client through the way of metamorphosis, step by step, with a lot of respect, but nevertheless, you have to be clever, creative, and courageous.
Thank you. I keep at the end of our conversation, metamorphosis, archetype.
Unconscious.
Conscious, unconscious, dilemma. And this beautiful way that you can combine and you can declare the definition of coaching, which is art and science.
In quite short time, because we speak only about 6 weekends. This is quite a miracle, really. I'm shocked how much knowledge people acquire in comparatively in a very short time. It's been a real pleasure to talk to you, really. I feel like a friend. Thank you so much for your,
for
your openness and smile and invitation.
Thank you.
Okay. Just 3 minutes before Avi goes to the main part of our webinar, Iris, would you like to tell us a bit why it's important to choose accredited programs? Because you are an ICF expert, so maybe you could share with the group why it is important.
Νομίζω ότι τώρα μπορούμε να μιλήσουμε όλοι ελληνικά.
Μιλά ελληνικά.
Καταλαβαίνω. Καταλαβαίνω λίγο.
Λοιπόν, πολύ σύντομα θα σας πω γιατί είναι αναγκαίο να επιλέξουμε ένα accredited πρόγραμμα. Όμως πριν το πω, θα ήθελα να σας διευκρινίσω 2 terms τα οποία χρησιμοποιούμε συχνά και μπορεί να μην ξέρουμε ακριβώς τι σημαίνει. Accreditation σημαίνει διαπίστευση και αφορά το πρόγραμμα, όχι τη σχολή και όχι το άτομο. Credential σημαίνει διαπίστευση και αυτή δίνεται στο άτομο το οποίο παρακολουθεί ένα accredited πρόγραμμα, ένα διαπιστευμένο πρόγραμμα και στη συνέχεια δίνει τις εξετάσεις αξιολόγηση, το performance evaluation και μπορεί να αποκτήσει το credential από τον φορέα του, στην προκειμένη περίπτωση, από το International Coaching Federation. Ένα πρόγραμμα είναι διαπιστευμένο όταν έχει περάσει από αυστηρά ποιοτικά και ποσοτικά κριτήρια από τον ICF, ούτως ώστε στη συνέχεια η σχολή να μπορεί να οδηγήσει τους υποψηφίους coaches σε credential. Τώρα θα μου πείτε γιατί χρειάζεται να είμαστε διαπιστευμένοι, γιατί χρειάζεται ένα accredited πρόγραμμα. Και θα ανατρέξω σε ένα αποτέλεσμα της έρευνας που έτρεξε ο ICF μέσα στο 2020 και λέει ότι το 81% των ερωτηθέντων πελατών απάντησαν ότι προτιμούν έναν διαπιστευμένο coach. Τι σημαίνει λοιπόν να είσαι διαπιστευμένος για τον πελάτη? Διαπιστευμένος είναι ο coach ο οποίος προσφέρει επαγγελματικές coaching υπηρεσίες υψηλών προδιαγραφών και έχει εκπαιδευτεί από ένα διαπιστευμένο πρόγραμμα αναγνωρισμένο από τον μεγαλύτερο και παλιότερο φορέα coaching, το International Coaching Federation. Ο διαπιστευμένος coach έχει επάρκεια γνώσεων και όχι μόνο αυτό και δεξιοτήτων, υπηρετεί το επάγγελμα με επαγγελματική συμπεριφορά ακολουθώντας τους κώδικες της δεοντολογίας και της ηθικής που ορίζει ο ICF. Βρίσκεται σε μια συνεχή επαγγελματική και προσωπική εξέλιξη και ανάπτυξη. Πώς? Μέσω της εκπαίδευσης, του supervision, της εποπτείας και του mentoring. Αξιολογείται για την επάρκεια των γνώσεών του σε τακτά χρονικά διαστήματα. Εσείς συνεργάτες και φίλοι coaches ξέρετε ότι κάθε 3 χρόνια είμαστε σε μια διαδικασία να αξιολογηθεί το επίπεδο των γνώσεών μας, οι ώρες που έχουμε με τον πελάτη, ούτως ώστε ο ICF που κάνει την αξιολόγηση να μας δώσει τη δυνατότητα της ανανέωσης της διαπίστευσής μας ή της αναβάθμισής μας σε κάποια ανώτερο credential. Και να πούμε και κάτι άλλο, ότι ο coach ο διαπιστευμένος παρακολουθεί τα τρέχοντα γεγονότα, είναι μέσα στα πράγματα, παρακολουθεί τα best practices. Πώς? Διότι ανήκει σε μια μεγάλη οικογένεια που είναι αυτό το community του ICF, που μέσα από αυτή τη κοινότητα μοιράζονται εμπειρίες, βέλτιστες πρακτικές, γίνονται συνέδρια, webinars, trainings και έτσι ο διαπιστευμένος coach βρίσκεται συνεχώς σε μια επαγγελματική αξιολόγηση. Και τέλος, ποιος είναι ο διαπιστευμένος coach? Είναι ο καταλήτης της αλλαγής για τον πελάτη. Είναι αυτός ο οποίος κάνει coach τον άνθρωπο και δεν επιλύει το πρόβλημα. Ευχαριστώ.
Ευχαριστούμε, Iris. Are we ready for burnout? Κρατήστε ερωτήσεις, θα τις απαντήσουμε είτε στο τέλος, είτε μας τις σημειώνετε, μας τις στέλνετε Facebook ή στο μήνυμα που έχετε λάβει το link για να σας τις απαντήσουμε και να συνεχίσουμε και το διάλογο. Avi, it's yours, the microphone.
Yep. View speaker. I don't see. Let's see if I start speaking, if I see myself now. Okay, maybe gallery would help. Full screen. Okay. Gallery view, bravo. Okay, I was asked to lecture and demonstrate a way of Jungian coaching thinking in the presence of a current dilemma that would be mental burnout in corporate life. And we cannot speak about anything nowadays without taking under consideration the corona pandemic that pushed people to work from home. And most of you are acquainted with this phenomena and process that people in the beginning liked to work with their pajamas, but siga found themselves with fatigue, clumsiness, eating too much and gaining weight or losing weight, being nervous. Parallel to this, the graph of aggression, first in the way they speak and then in the way they act. But if we zoom out from corona and we speak about burnout, generally speaking, people complain about the following symptoms. I used to go work, wake up vigorously to go to work, and now I'm not so enthusiastic anymore. Or bipolarity, a person that goes to work but forgets to go home, not because he or she not so much enthusiastic about the job that they do anymore, but because they neglected other areas in life, spiritual areas, creative areas, sport areas, and they narrow-minded themselves to doing more of the same. In addition, we have psychosomatic problems, headache, lower back pain, sweating, difficulty to concentrate for a long time, decrease of visual potential, need for glasses, and so on. And when people come for coaching under the umbrella of burnout, they usually don't come with the title, "I suffer burnout." They come and they start complaining about something much more general, like, "Lately, I'm not enthusiastic," or "My partner in life says that I'm not the same person anymore." Or they can relate to coaching because of a crisis, a temper tantrum, a headache, psychosomatic symptoms. And we, by listening carefully to their stories, arrive eventually to the aha, we have a burnout phenomena here. And the question is how Jungian coaching refers to burnout symptoms and dilemma. And for this, with your permission, I want to use, let's call it Jungian coaching dictionary presentation, because I need to install several Jungian terms in order to analyze the burnout phenomena. By the way, this is exactly what we do in Jungian coaching. We hear the dilemma, and then we translate the dilemma in Jungian terms, and then we know what to do, because Jung knew in his psychology to point out at solutions and directions that will fit the client. So let's do screen share. And just a minute, slideshow. From the beginning, bravo. Iris, do you see what I see? Yes? Ne, bravo. Okay. First of all, I want to explain this paradigm that I developed, that when a client comes usually with a dilemma, in psychotherapy is expecting to get solution. In general coaching method, he expects the client to be taken along with the coach on a coaching process to find a solution. Whereas the Iris asked me about the uniqueness, the added value of Jungian coaching, in our method, we will send the client to the unconscious to sort out a Jungian coaching in the kit, to sort out an experience, and the experience will bring out innovative idea. So you see, there is the conscious level where the coaching office is held, And the dilemma, instead of analyzing the dilemma and talking about it, we will send the client for an experience in the unconscious, and eventually, apparently, the unconscious will give the client a hint, usually it's a hint, for the innovative solution. You see, here we have a beautiful picture that we designed in Jungian coaching to show you the corporate life and the individual life and how the archetypes correspond and are parallel on both levels of the conscious level, the unconscious level, and the collective unconscious, which is archetypes that are common to all human beings. So keep in mind, the burnout phenomena takes place on the ego level, on the conscious mind. And this is a graph that wants to show you the ego functioning. I want to be sure that you did understand that the client, synonym word for a client is ego, ego. I am coming to you, the coach, and I want to present my life. In this case, my burnout life. So I ask the client, how much are you invested? Remember this word, invested, in your career, between 0 to 10, he says, 10, I work around the clock. What is your financial situation between 1 to 10? He says, fairly 8. How much are you invested in your health? To tell you the truth, Okirio Savi, I haven't gone to the doctor for many months. I don't know. Lately, I have some symptoms, migraine, my knee, my right knee. I haven't been to the dentist. So there is a decrease in the burnout situation, a decrease of the health, or increase of psychosomatic problems. Adelfes, no friends. Family. Actually, to tell you the truth, my wife said, if you don't go to get help, I want to consider divorce. Oh my God. Cristo. So a family is not so good. To the kids, he doesn't have nerves. I see people are laughing and smiling. That's good to learn with humor. And the family is not his highlight. An intimate relationship in burnout. What is this, he says. What is this? Lack of spirituality. He stopped going to church because he is a bit depressed. Not to speak about voluntary communal contribution. Nada, nothing, tipota, in personal growth. And of course, not pleasure. How does he nurture the physical environment? Low. So if you see, we call it pizza. If you see the pizza of the burnout, the classical burnout person will have a lot of investment in career, quite well economically, but all the rest is quite negligent. Now, let me take you to the story of the hero quest. Now, this is again learning a bit Jung. So you see, this is consciousness, what you know, what you see, what your family sees, what your friends see, what you think, what you process. On the overt level is consciousness, and the hero is the ego. Deep, 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 deep in the unconscious lies the self archetype. And there is a telecommunication between the ego, and the self that is called in Jungian terms, ego-self axis. How does the self speak to the ego? Through dreams, art, and some light drugs, and alcohol. How does the ego speak to the self by what you do? These circles are the activity of the person. And when you act, it influences yourself. So there is reciprocity. If we go back to burnout situation, the ego becomes narrow and there is a cut from the self. The ego axis is disconnected and the person is very lonely. Polymono. Here are 15 stages. Please, please close your microphone. Christopoli. This is a map of the Hero Quest. Hero Quest, in simple words, in 60 seconds, is the process that we are running in our life, both on the career, on family, on learning, anything that is characterized by development. And this quest is divided, according to Campbell the Jungian, into three parts: the departure, the initiation, and the return. Let's speak about a 50 years old businessman who inherited the business from his patera. And he overcame the big crisis that Greece passed several years ago. But now, with the corona, he is really burned out. We can imagine how his pizza looks like. His father woke him up one morning and said, I want you to join the business. He said, I want to be a theater actor. He sent him to therapy. He sent him to Manchester. He studied business administration. And now he in Manchester, it was quiet, lonely. And now he's fighting already 10 years, the road of trials to arrive to a success. But Corona pushed him into the belly of the whale. What is the belly of the whale? Represents the final separation from the hero known world. He used to know the job and enter to the stage, the person shows willingness to undergo metamorphosis. When you are in burnout, your only solution to move out from burnout is to go into the metamorphosis. And how can you do it? You have to dive to the unconscious. Now, ladies and gentlemen, allow me to take you to the unconscious. I'm going to show you another presentation that will show you pictures. Let me tell you a secret. Each picture represents an archetype. And the pictures will move every 30 seconds. Don't worry, it will come again and again. And all I ask you is to allow the picture to choose you. Please notice, I'm not saying choose a picture because then I give your ego the job. I'm saying, let the pictures appeal you. And each picture has a number. And I want you to write down three numbers of three archetypes that here, Edo Ketora, you chose, which will be a sampling of your unconscious. Don't think too much, choose the pictures. Ikiria Masura, post chrono echo.
Poso chrono echete? 35 minutes.
Wow, bravo. So let's do a screen share and let's hope that I find it fast. Wait. Ena lepta. No. Stop sharing. Exit. This is the real race. Wait a minute. Exit. And exit. I'm just wiping all the screens to arrive to Markela's file and to find the. Echo. Bravo, Abby. Okay, I'm sharing the screen with you guys. Do you see what I see?
Yes.
Haristopoli. Okay. So you have seen twice, and I hope you have three choices. Yeah, can you do this to me if you have already your three choices? You click on reactions. Sisi Demechis. Trio numero, Echis. Μπράβο. Ο κύριος Τηλεμάχος Πούλης, έχεις? Τρία εικόνα έχεις, Αριστόπουλη. Okay, now. Please open your microphone so that I have a little talk with you guys. Welcome.
Mm-hmm. Welcome.
Now, let's imagine you are all suffering of burnout, just for the simulation, okay? I want one volunteer to show you how I work with the unconscious to give you an illustration of the innovative potential of the archetypes. But before we go into this, let me tell you something about attraction to an archetype. Attraction to an archetype. When you're attracted to archetype, it's either you possess it, you have it, or you wish to have it. For example, you know adolescents, they put a poster of Schwarzenegger or Rambo or Tarzan and Lady Gaga and Madonna because they want to be near the archetype. Mm. It's like the ancient Greeks, they put their statue of their goddess like Hestia in their home. So you want to approximate with the archetype. And therefore, the three pictures that you chose denote either you have it or you wish to have it. So do I have one courageous person to volunteer and work with me with the three choices to explain? Bravo, Effie. Okay. Open your microphone and wait for my horloge to stop. Yeah. Tell me, my dear, what is your profession? What do you do these days? Just to know. I'm checking, by the way, I'm checking your ego pizza. Yeah.
I have studied marketing and currently I don't work. I'm in a process of finding a new job.
Depressed or optimistic?
Depressed. Nowadays. Depressed.
Bravo, good for us. Okay. I really appreciate your volunteering. Tell me the numbers and maybe we will see it if I can bring the here. Tell me the number, please.
9.
Ένα λεπτά. Yeah.
21.
Yeah.
37.
How much?
37.
Okay, this is very interesting. Let me explain to you. Usually in Jungian coaching, behind this card, you will have the explanation what it denotes. This archetype is the archetype of mediation, of bringing the polarities together. You see that there is a lot of similarity between the masculine and the feminine figure, so much that they unite. It's the uniting. She is symbolizing Luna Figari, the femininity, and he is representing Ilios, the sun. So it's bringing together the polarities. Your other choice is a duplication of this archetype. It is the conjunctio, bringing together. Before we go to this one, 37, I want to talk to you, so I'll stop sharing a moment. Now, this is a coaching method. How does it appeal to you that out of your unconscious, you are inviting the skill of mediation, of bridging, of communicating between people, of bringing two sides together? And what has this to do with marketing?
With marketing, I guess it has to, because usually you have to pitch your idea and express ideas and make other people buy your idea, both internally in the company and externally. So you have to
Tell me, my dear, do you have Netflix?
Yes.
You must, if you haven't seen, the movie that is running now, Emily in Paris.
I have seen it.
You've seen it. So she's an expert of marketing. And you see that she needs to mediate her ideas to the French beach. Not that her ideas are not good, but she cannot do anything with her ideas unless she's using this skill of mediation that you are attracted. Do you know how to mediate, or you want to come to Jungian coaching to learn? I'm starting to market myself too.
I understood. Yes, I'm thinking of it, yes.
Yeah, so let's look at the third card, because you wasted one energy because you chose a double card of mediation.
I thought so because I was between two numbers, but I think, yeah.
But it seems that it is very, very important for you to bring two to one. Think about it. I don't know you at all, but the unison, to bring conflict into a solution, to bring two parties into collaboration, to bring contradicting materials into a fusion. This is very, very strong, whether you have it or you are very much attracted to it. Okay? Mm-hmm. And now we go to the third one. The third one is the red umbrella. It's the ability to individuate and become yourself, not like all the others. Now, in order to become yourself, not all like the others, you need to be aggressive. Between 1 to 5, how aggressive can you to start moving from your comfort zone out?
3, 2 to 3.
What do you think needs to be done that it will be 5?
Be more courageous and trust more myself.
How did you have courage to volunteer in front of 44 people?
I didn't think that I needed courage to volunteer. I was interesting to see what the process. So
you say something very, very, very important, that when it has to do with learning, you take risks.
Yes.
Between 1 to 5, how optimistic you feel when you talk to me now?
4 to 5. 4.
Bravo. So you see, I didn't plan anything. You were choosing cards. I will show you the cards again and choose the card that will be your psychopomp, the one that would lead you on your quest, okay? Use your intuition. Don't think. Just choose and I will show you. Wait a minute. When you have the card that you choose, tell me.
This one.
Yeah, this one is the hero. This one is the hero. In coaching, I was taught that I have to help you arrive to giving yourself homework till you see me next time. Out of this very Grigora talk, what homework can you take to yourself in the sense of practicing hero?
Mm-hmm.
I will tell you, you have to move from out of your comfort zone. Can you do something to move out of your comfort zone this week?
This week, in a week?
No, just one step this week that you will say, oh boy, I'm out of my comfort zone.
Yes, I can.
Bravo, what?
send my CV to a person that I'm a little bit scared to send.
Yeah, you have to do it. Ακριβώς. Ακριβώς. Βέβαια. Πολύ ωραία. Okay, my dear, it was nice meeting you.
Thank you.
And I think we have to open the stage for questions. And Christina is there. Do you want to ask something, my dear? I want to thank you all for your patience, courage, and curiosity for coming and investing your time. Please. Μια ερώτηση.
I didn't want to ask anything. I just wanted to say I really enjoyed watching that. Thank you.
Yeah. Yamas.
Yes. Yamas.
My tsipouro is in the freezer. Any questions that you want to pose, please?
Hi, can I ask a question, please?
Yeah, can you open your camera, dear?
Unfortunately, I'm on a PC and I don't have a camera right now.
Okay, so we will stay in the feminine domain. Darkness is femininity.
Okay, no problem. I'll take it. So, what if it's hard for us to choose only three numbers? I mean, I was very intrigued by a few of the pictures, but I chose, my final choice was four numbers, not three.
Then in a, it's not important. I say three just because of time. It's about dialoguing with the cards. This is what it is about. It's about sorting out and dialoguing with the cards, because as you saw with Effie, the dialogue stimulates the person and brings out ideas, point of view, innovations, and this is the idea, and to end up with a little homework in order to step forward. Yeah.
Okay,
you know, when we study about femininity and masculinity, I explained the symbolism of three and four, and three is a symbol for masculinity. You know, like the cross that you go 1, 2, 3, unlike the circle and the square that are feminine. So when I say three, is there is an unconscious message, let's be practical. Let's be on the being and not on the doing.
Perfect, thank you so much.
May I also ask you something?
Yes, Maria Calogiani.
Thank you. So this has little to do with the mental burnout, but of course it's relative to everything that we've been talking about today. In the beginning of the lecture, you said that when someone comes to you, you can separate their personal psychological problems and help them coach either the institution or the client in a practical way. My question to you is, you can do this, okay, but the coach themselves, how do they separate their own psychological problems from, you know, the coaching that they're conducting or the solutions that they're trying to, you know, apply to their company or the dilemma that they have?
They take supervision, they go to a mentor, they learn themselves. But I thought you were asking something else that I want to use the opportunity. What is the differentiation between clinical depression and burnout? And this goes, what is the difference between psychotherapy and coaching? When you ask a person that comes for coaching, for how long your pizza is so narrow? If a person suffers of clinical depression, then the pizza is narrow for many, many years. It's chronic. Burnout is a shrinking situation, as a result of ego inflation, which means doing too much, over putting overburden on your shoulder. So if it's temporary, then it goes for coaching. If it's chronical, then you'd better send the person to a good psychiatrist or clinical psychologist to work out on the depression. But burnout is a symptom and not a chronic disease. And how do you differ your own problems? You take supervision.
Hi, I have a question as well. Hello, Avi.
Yes.
I was intrigued by the use of the word dilemma, and I wanted to ask you, why don't you use the word issue or problem, a problem that leads to a solution? Why do you pick dilemma? Dilemma is, you know, actually has two ways of getting solved, or you have two issues on your mind. So why dilemma and not issue?
I think America, this is an American profession, and Americans, they don't like the word patient, they call it client, and they don't like problems. Trump has no problems whatsoever, but he has many dilemmas. So it's an American jargon of the profession, I think. But in my book, I use many times issue, for example, with the shadow, I ask, choose an issue or a problem or dilemma or a theme that you want to discuss and so on. So I think it's the professional jargon. Yes. Right. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Can I ask something, Avi?
Yes, yes.
Stella, Kladeberg used the same word, dilemma, and usually gives a solution how you can face dilemma. And he doesn't use problem, because problem is something stuck. Dilemma has a space, a room of development.
Okay, right. Okay, thank you.
Nice question, though. Maybe μια ερωτησή από τον άντρες. One gentleman to come up with a question. Mavrikos, give me a question. Mavrikos is a graduate, a businessman who graduated our program.
Avi, I would like to know why somebody can
you say one word? Say one more time, Avi. I miss you so much. I need to hear this voice.
Avi Mu.
Λοιπόν,
why someone can follow the program in individual part and the corporation part? I would like to explain to everybody why we can follow you, why we have to do it, because this is has to do with magic, not only study, yeah. Not only
Michali, speak Elinika.
Okay.
Μίλες ελληνικά.
Αυτό που θέλουμε να ακούσουμε είναι πώς θα βγει ο άλλος αλλαγμένος μέσα από αυτό το πρόγραμμα και πώς μπορεί να κερδίσει και στην προσωπική ζωή αλλά και στην επαγγελματική ζωή αυτή τη διαφοροποίηση. Αυτό το πράγμα που εμείς το νιώσαμε, έχουμε τελειώσει το πρόγραμμα, έχουμε αντιληφθεί τι σημαίνει να κάνουμε Jungian Coach. Το θέμα είναι να καταλάβουν και οι υπόλοιποι ποιο θα είναι το πραγματικό όφελος του να ολοκληρώσουν μια τέτοια σπουδή.
Anybody wants to show his three choices and to analyze it together? I mean, if we have time, do we have time, Marili?
We have 10 minutes.
And you, okay, so what do you suggest? Another dive
maybe answer to Michali. to ask how a person changes during that program, and then we can go with someone else with another trial.
The program is very gradual, surprisingly. We go very, very slowly, and it goes one step of theory, one step of experiencing, one step of theory, one step of experiencing, because it's about coaching. You need to know what is behind the card, what is behind the theory, and how it applies to you, to your personality, because unless you experience it, you cannot possibly encourage, accompany, and support your client to dive and to experience. And through this gradual process of experiencing, learning cognitively, open up to knowledge, we work with a lot of Greek mythology, a lot of storytelling, a lot of intellectual knowledge that you acquire, and slowly, slowly, we experience what we learn. And this experiential learning is turning you into a different person. Because if you need to deal with your own skia, shadow, and if you need to deal, if you're a man, with your own femininity, and if you're a woman and you deal with your own masculinity, and if you practice how to manipulate and become a trickster when it's required, and when you go into the hero quest and you do irregular things out of your comfort zone, then after 6 months, another bonus of this program is that it's very therapeutic without therapy.
Okay. We have also another question that goes, Avi, how can we prevent burnout? Is there a way? The pandemic is not going to finish anytime soon.
Yes, I thought it was very obvious that you must balance your life. You have to do the opposite side of what you do in the routine. If you are X hours on the computer, you have to do recreation, nature, art, cooking, learn. This is great time for expanding your knowledge. This is great time for learning. This is great time for expanding your personality. Don't sit like a bear in a winter under 30 centigrade in Russia and wait to eat your fat and shrink. Use the facilities to expand yourself. And the moment you expand yourself, when Corona is over, you will be double muscled with potential.
Okay.
Is it possible to say once more how ego communicates with the self and vice versa? Thank you. Yes, of course. When you go to church, when you go to church and you bend innocently on your knees and you listen to the psalm, to the prayer, and you surrender inward, you meet your divine spirituality, which is one of the cells that human beings look for, spiritual feeling. So the ego is what you do. And the self is the God inside you, said Jung, who was a son of a priest.
Okay. Is there anybody that would like to make a question in Greek? Μπορεί να θέλει κάποιος να κάνει μια ερώτηση στα ελληνικά.
Okay. Να ρωτήσω κάτι εγώ.
Ναι.
Can ask a question. Avi, we know one of the major competence is the relationship with a client. And when we coach a client, usually we're one piece. Yes. When we work with the unconscious part of the client, do we work with the unconscious part of ourselves? This is a question.
There is an archetype that Jung used, and it's called the wounded healer, and it's based on the Greek mythology of Chiron.
Ochironas.
Ochironas. Wait a minute. Do you see this slide?
Yes.
This is the client, and the client is dealing with his unconscious. On the side sits the coach, who also have an unconscious. There is a communication of the unconscious between the client and the coachee, the coach, between the coachee and the coach. And when the coach listens to the material of the coachee, in the unconscious, it affects him. For example, let's say that a woman who got cancer in the breast is coming for coaching. And she speaks about how terrified she is because she goes into operation. The coach is meeting in his unconscious his own fears and becomes wounded. Now, here is a great paradox. The moment the coach becomes weak, paradoxically, the client becomes strong. So the coachee says to the coach, I see you became pale. And the coach says, well, it affects me. I am very, very worried about you. And then the coachee says, don't worry, Iris, I will be okay. Because of this paradox, and this is embedded, because Hieronas, what did he say to Heraclius? He said, don't worry, let me bleed in my own blood and I will cure. So we are devoting some time for understanding the contract, the hidden contract in coaching. Unlike psychologists and psychotherapists that must be strong, the coach can be human because the coachee has the power.
So we meet, we talk about a mutual transformation.
Mutual transformation, mutual responsibility, symmetry, a lot of symmetry. And I keep telling my students in Jungian coaching, you don't need to do the job. In Budapest, for example, when I observed how they worked, I said, listen, if the coach speaks more than the coachee, it's bad coaching. Let the coachee work with the cards and let the cards answer to the coachee. You are Aegean Airlines stewardess. Coffee, tea, tea, coffee. That's it. All the rest, it's between the coachee and the kit that you are, you know, as a Jungian coach, how to operate. Alicia Thianomanduva. Calovradi.
Okay, so any other questions before the landing?
Siklamino, I saw you. Good evening.
Εδώ βλέπετε και κάποιους οι οποίοι θα είναι παλαιότεροι Jungian coaches και οι οποίοι θα είναι και assistants στο πρόγραμμα αυτή τη χρονιά. Αυτούς χαιρετάει ο Άβη. Τι θεανό, την
έλεγχο. This is another thing. We are working in a very, Signomi, we are working in the program in a very, very nice structure. The students that are really prominent, that are wonderful, we offer them to become assistants and then they benefit for another generation, but they sit with the students when they practice, they meet them between modules, they read with them texts, and they empower them and they gain for themselves hours of coaching. So we have a wonderful team of assistants that will start working with us because previous generation, we were pioneers, but now we have already a generation of people like Maria Drubani and others that are qualified and they know what I speak about. Don't you, Maria?
So thank you all for coming.
One more question. Someone is asking about the information about the program when it starts.
With this, I wanted to say that if someone is not following us on social media, we can post, we will send you with you an email with the social media account, so you can follow us and learn more about that. Or you can email us and we can send you the brochure and the all information about the program.
We will send
Or you can Google Jungian Coaching School and click on the Greek flag, and you will have all the information you need for the domestic school. And next week we are launching a modern upgraded version of the site, so you will have all the information, including the domestic schools.
Thank you, Iris. Thank you, Avi. Thank you to the assistants that were with us. Thank you to everybody. You can
Εγώ σας ευχαριστώ πολύ.
Μπορείτε να μας στείλετε και άλλες ερωτήσεις και ό,τι άλλο επιθυμείτε. Πιθανότατα θα σας στείλουμε, θα γίνει και ένα άλλο webinar αργότερα με θέμα τη μεταεπαγγελματική μας πορεία που μπορούμε να έχουμε αν γίνουμε coach ή την μεταλλαγή που μπορούμε να κάνουμε. Τη μετάλλαξη, μεταλλαγή, ωραία λέξη. Αυτά από μας και καλό βράδυ σε όλους.
Ευχαριστούμε πολύ. Καλό βράδυ.
Ευχαριστούμε πολύ.
Καλό βράδυ.
Καλό βράδυ. Ευχαριστούμε πολύ.
Καλό βράδυ. Ευχαριστούμε. Γεια σας.
Ευχαριστούμε. Καλό βράδυ.
Ευχαριστώ.
Ευχαριστούμε, Εφη.
Bye, Avi.
Bye.
Miss you, Avi.
Miss you soon.
Hopefully.
Bye, Avi. Bye, Avi.
Oi, Nico. Filakia.
We miss you. We miss you. Come.